What's up, internet? I am Manish from rebellionrider.com and I am back once again with another short and crispy PLSQL tutorial. In today's video, we will discuss the introduction to the Native Dynamic SQL, most commonly known as Dynamic SQL. Before jumping onto this tutorial, I just want to ask you guys something. We have covered almost all the concepts of PLSQL on our YouTube channel. This Dynamic SQL series might be the last of the PLSQL concepts. If there is any topic which I have forgotten to cover, then please let me know. You can tell me the name of the topic either in the comment section, or you can also leave your suggestions on my Facebook page as well as on my Twitter. You can find all the links in the description of this video. That being said, let's come back to our today's topic, which is the introduction to PLSQL Native Dynamic SQL. But first, let's see what is a static SQL. As the name suggests, any SQL statement which does not change during the runtime and remains fixed is called a static SQL statement. The advantage of static SQL statements is that we already know whether all the dependent objects over which we are writing the statement are present or not. And the biggest advantage of static SQL is that we hard code these statements into our application, thus we can tune them for optimal performance. But sometimes hard coding something into the application is not the solution. That's why we need dynamic SQL. So, what is this Native Dynamic SQL? Again, as the name suggests, any SQL statement which is constructed at the runtime is called Dynamic SQL. As these statements are built on the fly, thus they cannot be hard-coded into the application, which in turn increases the flexibility. Whereas static SQL lets you execute only DML statements inside your PLSQL block, the dynamic SQL enables you to execute DDL statements and that too inside your PLSQL block. Which means using dynamic SQL, you can create a table or drop an index or truncate your table right inside your PLSQL block. This is an advantage of Native Dynamic SQL over static SQL. You can head over to my blog to read more about the advantages and disadvantages of static as well as dynamic SQL. Find the link in the description of this video. Okay, now you may be thinking,
but can't we build PLSQL on the fly?
Yes, we can. Similar to dynamic SQL, the process of constructing PLSQL code at runtime is called dynamic PLSQL. So, how do we use dynamic SQL in Oracle database? The two most common methods of using dynamic SQL and PLSQL in Oracle database are execute immediate statement and open for fetch and close block. Yeah, the same block which we saw in the cursor tutorial. Apart from these two most commonly used methods, the other ways of using dynamic SQL or PLSQL are bulk fetch, bulk execute immediate, bulk for all, and bulk collect into statement. We have learned all the above commands and statements in the previous series on bulk data processing. If you haven't watched those videos, then I will share the link of the playlist in the description. Do check it out. In the next video, we will do some practical demonstration on how to build a dynamic SQL statement in Oracle database. But those tutorials will require a working knowledge of bind variables. Luckily, I have already done a detailed video as well as blog on the PLSQL bind variables. Again, you can find the links in the description. That's all in this tutorial on the introduction to PLSQL Native Dynamic SQL in Oracle database. Hope you enjoyed watching. If so, please give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. Also, if you are new to this channel, go ahead and subscribe right away, as in the next tutorial, we will be exploring dynamic SQL to its next level. Also, follow me on my Facebook. It's facebook.com/therebellionrider. Thanks and have a great day.